ladies and gentlemen, to present to you a little bit about his story and about the story of the Purple Pine Foundation. Please welcome to the microphone, Foundress Maria Porthos.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
What counts in life is not the mere fact that we have lived. It is what difference we have made in the life of others that will determine the significance of the life we lead. Nelson Mandela. It all started with one little boy, my son Logan. I needed to make a difference for him when he was going through cancer. During this journey as a mother, a teacher, I felt it was my obligation to make a difference for him. But not only for him, but for my two daughters who were living this journey with him, and other children who shared similar experiences, who had life-threatening illnesses. During that time, something in me awakened, much more than it had for the many years before when I taught in mainstream schools. Aside from Logan, many of my students needed attention. They needed that extra care and love that the mainstream system could not provide for them for many various reasons. I was adamant to be the person who would make a difference for the children on a much larger scale. Children with severe illnesses, children who were being bullied for their sexual orientation, children with dyslexia who thought of themselves as stupid and did not believe in themselves, children with Asperger's and on the autism spectrum who felt they didn't belong, children who thought of themselves as less than others because of their race or social and economic status. I wanted to be the safe person. I wanted to provide a safe space for them. These children needed me, and they needed a place where they could grow and discover more of their authentic self. When I started the then Silver Lining Homeschool on October 1st, 2014, one of my main concerns was what would be my role as a mentor. My role and that of every educator and person who comes into contact with the Purple Pine children is to awaken their hidden potential, to encourage free thinking, to give them an education that is not driven by just facts and figures, but rather by building up their potential as human beings. It is okay to strive for academic excellence. However, it is extremely fundamental that our children find that ground beneath their feet, so that they can too become like me and you, resilient adults capable of making wise choices for self and for the other. Many of us here are a product of a somewhat outdated model of education, so it can be difficult to imagine an alternative method to what we know and grew up with. We live in an age where people will have questions about our foundation because of our long-held traditions. It is our responsibility not only to educate our population, but more so to make sure that we are innovative in doing so. Therefore, they can have the life skills they need and are ready to meet the up-and-coming future. And this cannot be achieved by just sitting them at desks for most of their school life. We also have a duty to teach our children about empathy, strength, courage, respect, all the watchwords and pillars of this foundation. Having independence is nothing without these virtues. So it is imperative that our education system also takes a more keen interest in the holistic formation of each child. My job is to provide meaning and purpose to every child who crosses this evergreen path. Being a mentor a confidant, and teaching my children that it is possible to joyfully coexist with each other while being of different ages, backgrounds, races, beliefs, and cultures is not a job. It is a vocation, and one that is fundamental to our human existence. I would like to thank all of you present this afternoon for your willingness to trust us as we embark on this path towards healing and growth. Thank you for taking the time to present to and with us this afternoon. Thank you for hearing our story. I am eternally grateful and especially honored that Isabel chose us as her Beauty with a Purpose project. Isabel, you could have gone elsewhere. You could have decided to take on a project that may have not been so challenging. But I am glad you crossed our path. I am in awe that our meeting has enriched your experience as well. As a woman, a beauty queen, and a daughter of Trinidad and Tobago. I am grateful that you have allowed yourself to become vulnerable as you spent these past few weeks listening to the experiences of our children and their parents. We are truly grateful to you, Isabel, for building so many bridges, while at the same time fearlessly breaking down the many walls and barriers which stood before us. Because of your courage and strength, your resilience and networking skills, your unapologetic advocacy, today we have our own home. I am reminded, as I watch this project unveil before my eyes, that there is still so much good in this world. To you, your team, and the Miss World Trinidad and Tobago franchise, thank you for standing with us and for teaching us to fish. As I close, I leave you with a few words to reflect on. To whom much is given, much is expected. You, Isabel, have already won our vote of confidence. You have already fast-tracked your way into our humble forest. You have already left a living impression in the hearts of not just us and the Purple Pine Foundation, but on the heart of Trinidad and Tobago. Now, my queen, arise and take your rightful place in the world.
Bring that round.
Ladies and gentlemen, hello, and welcome to the official launch of the Purple Pine Foundation. When I walked into the casting call for Miss World, what seems like a lifetime ago, I had no idea that my life would change so dramatically. I had no idea that it would be filled with all the love, laughter, and the hope that I've experienced in partnering with the Purple Pine Foundation. By way of background, the organization was initially known as the Silver Lining Foundation, founded by Marie Goldfrust in 2014 to provide education for extraordinary children. What started off as her vision in one small room of a building in Maribel has blossomed. It has transformed into this beautiful foundation before you today. And I am so blown away by the support that we have received in the provision of so many products and services. I just don't know where to start to thank everyone. We received a logo and web support, awareness on national television programs, cash donations, AC units and installations, fridge and microwave, other kitchen appliances, flooring, electricals, general contracting, yard work, grading, paving, topsoil, blocks, steel, brass, you name it. Everything was done to this yard. Plants, security cameras, drapes, signage and wallpaper, murals, fire and safety services, stationery, legal fees, and even the tents that we are fortunate to be standing under today as I speak were donated to us. So And all of these amazing contributions have been made possible by all of you here today. The total cost of all of this improvement is in the realm of $382,029 and counting. That is an extraordinary amount of support that you and the community of Trinidad and Tobago has contributed to making our vision and my vision for these children a reality. And I think you should give yourselves a round of applause. And I want to thank you not only for your physical donations and labor, but for your contribution in the more important intangible way towards our goal of creating a fairer, more just, and equitable society. Because the work that Marie Colthrust does every day as an educator from 7 in the morning until late in the evening is just that. So this is not just a special school for children with different learning capacities. This is a revolutionary concept and idea for Trinidad and Tobago and globally. It is a safe space for children with many different abilities, identities, and skills who have found that they are unable to thrive in mainstream education. We want to see them thrive. We want to foster that spirit of inclusion and tolerance that is so beautiful. This, in effect, is a new institution in our society. It is an institution that speaks a new language of intersectionality and the resistance of oppression and marginalization in all its social forms, from stigma to emotional abuse and to physical abuse as well. It speaks to empowerment and ultimately to freedom for these 15 children from the constraints of their personal circumstances. And when I walk into their classrooms, when Ethan and Isaiah teach me how to skateboard, when Maya and Sumaya ask me to do a yoga class with them, and when Caitlin tells me about her interest in graphic design and deviant art, I don't see difference. I see myself in each one of you. We are the same. More than anything, with my efforts, I want to give you that feeling of sameness and that sense of belonging in this society that others may try their very best to take away from you. Don't allow them to do that. I want to restore that trust in others and in the good of people who make good their word to you. That there are people out there like me, Marie, my team, all the sponsors here today, all of the sponsors that couldn't come here today, and other well-wishers who genuinely want to see you do well and excel. Be the best that you can be. Follow your passions and your dreams, however big or small they might be. Without trust in me and this process and all that we've done, there can be no change. Too often in this society, we see people in positions of authority, political officials, family members, people who have seen us at our most weak and vulnerable, promise us the world and then let us down. We feel hurt and betrayed by those we trusted to take care of us and to be there for us. That feeling does not end at childhood. It continues to adulthood and beyond. And some people may say it's an unavoidable aspect of life. You have to live and you learn. We allow it to make us hard. We allow it to feel like the system is stacked against us and there's nothing that we can do, and we shut ourselves off from the world. We look at the newspapers with the same headlines every day, and we repeat the same reactions. Another allegation of corruption, another murder, the economic situation in Venezuela, the global refugee crisis, and more. And we allow ourselves to be drawn into that resigned acceptance of reality. And I want to change that. I want to create again that sense of hope and of love and community that I think is waiting for us right behind that curtain of resignation. Let us draw it back and open in that light again. And if I had said these words on August 5th, 2 months ago on the night of my coronation, I'm sure you wouldn't believe me, because that was before all the work on this foundation had started. And I would forgive you for not believing me and my promises. But I stand before you today, and this building and all its improvements are a testament that my dream has come true. My dream has been made a reality for all of these children here today. And my actions have matched my words. And after the speeches for this evening have been concluded and the ribbon has been cut, I invite you to come and see for yourself the difference that we have made in the lives of the children of the Purple Pine Foundation. Thank you.
We came from different places, but we all had the same story. They didn't want us, they didn't think we could live, so they starved us of food, not of drink. They starved us of knowledge, of rights, of education, of potential. They didn't want us, they didn't think we could live, so they gave us masks of names. Massive names they thought told our story. But it only takes one blessed soul, one person with eyes that see beyond masks and a heart that feels beyond names, to see that we are so much more. My mask falls away, as do the others. We found a place where we can be accepted, feel at peace, feel at home, and where we thrive on a rich diet of enlightenment, knowledge, and love. The girl in the pretty green dress, her name is actually Candace. My best friend is actually Jamil. And my name is actually Rowan.
On behalf of Rowan, my family, and myself, I'd like to make a small presentation to you. Just to say, to keep on inspiring, keep on doing the good thing, and thank you.